Hi, I have finally used geometry nodes, and they are incredible. It's a graph system in which an input geometry is connected to an output, and a wide range of operations can happen in between, like, for instance, this transform node. I turned to nodes because I needed a typewriter animation for my text. Traditional text has some animation capability, but it's very limited. Geometry nodes come to the rescue with a string-to-curve function. I will show how to get there in three steps. We will set up a graph that can display and slice text. We will add parameters to make it animatable. We will generate animation curves for our text. Blender Renaissance came up with this idea. Also, being an actual modern-day Renaissance man, he put that in rap form. Really, you should check his videos and subscribe to that channel. Those tunes are catchy. And since we are there, subscribe to this channel as well. You'll get updates of my videos and help me become a real YouTuber. Back to our graph. We will start storing our text inside a string input node. Then, we connect its knob to a string to curve node. Since the latter is connected to the output geometry, we can already see the hollow text in the viewport. Let's insert a fill curve operations to add a surface. I have changed the curve to angles for a better tessellation, but as far as I can see, in my case they look the same. We can also add an extrude mesh node if we want solid text. Finally, we pass our input through the slice string node, so that the start and end of the string can be changed dynamically. The first part is done. Now we can add a few input parameters and make our setup reusable. Since I deleted the initial one, I have to add a group input node. We will not use the geometry, since it's generated, but we are going to add custom knobs. In the graph region, I press N to display the properties, and press the plus icon in the input panel to add a new attribute. I'm going to call this one text, and select string as type, because we are going to put our text here. So I delete the string value node and connect my new knob instead. And the nice thing is, this input is displayed in the geometry node's modifier, and we can write everything here and change our text on duplicate objects, even if the node setup is the same. I add more controls, one for the start, that might be useful, and one to set the last displayed character. Both should be integers, and their minimum value should be 0. Okay, we have the effect we were looking for. We can add attributes to control the size, default to 1, and another for thickness, which should be a float type. That's it, we are set. All that is left to do is to animate this value. We could animate manually, but we can generate animation curves as well. I set one keyframe for the end value and open the graph editor. Then, in the animation curve properties, add a polynomial generator in the modifiers tab. That will create a linear animation. That kind of works, but it's too fast and regular. We can lower the X parameter to slow it down. We can see the curve flattening to a slower pace. Still, the regularity is weird. So I add a noise modifier. To avoid the jitter, I put the noise first in the modifier stack and check additive in the polynomial. This way, the animation always goes up. As a side effect, the animation starts too early, but we can lower the coefficient until the curve intersects 0 at our first frame. To get rid of some remaining tremble, we can add a stepped modifier. To add more lines, we can duplicate the objects and change its text. I also want to change its size. And now I see that this parameter was wrongly created as integer. It should be a float. there is a point in which the animated curve goes down, causing a letter to tremble. I lower the noise to fix that. Now, I want to offset the second animation so that it starts after the first line is finished. There is still excessive noise for this point. Okay, that's it. We could add more controls, but that's enough for the day. The great thing with the geometry nodes is that they add so many possibilities in such generic way. They were not added for the sake of Typewriter Effect. The devs designed an universal system that allows the more disparate purpose. I plan to delve more in the subject. For now, thanks for watching.